nästa gång, för då är ett nytt program på gång.
Nu är de hos oss igen med fjärde albumet Out of Body. And we'll all go together to flood wild mountain time. All around the blooming heather, will you go, lassie, go?
I think the Hooters are the Philadelphia music scene. I can't think of any other group that's still residing in Philadelphia that has had the kind of track record for quality work that they have.
When the Hooters released their independent release back in 85, they really took the city by a storm and really warranted a lot of national attention as well. And since then, they've really been the band by which every local band has been measured in Philadelphia. I know a lot of Philadelphia musicians are very aware of the Hooters and their success. So they're really still thought of as the Philadelphia band locally and nationally.
I often consider them like roving ambassadors for our city, carrying a Philadelphia message on, because they've truly been all around the world. And when you talk to them individually and you hear some of their experiences playing in Japan and playing not only across the United States, but playing in Japan and playing in Germany and France and England, and the experiences that they bring home, and then the fact that they bring a part of Philadelphia to those other areas, I think it's tremendously important to this area. They really serve as musical ambassadors, I like to think of them, and they do a really fine job of it. They're friendly, they bring this warmth to their performances, and so people equate them with the city, and the city, I think, should be tremendously proud of what they do for it.
Yeah. All right.
In the pocket, baby.
Out of body, here we go.
I'm dancing out on the edge.
slides like a shadow, and she fits anywhere. She falls like an angel down where there are no saints at all. There are no saints at all. Ooh, I can't touch her. Ooh, I can't reach her. You lose your way forever when you gaze into her eyes. And I'm dancing out on the edge. Yeah, I'm dancing out on the edge. Out on the edge. She's wild like the roses. No place for any man to rest in her garden. Red lips that kiss and tell you yes. They kiss and tell you yes. Ooh, I can't touch her. Ooh, I can't reach her. You lose your way forever every time you trip inside. And I'm dancing out on the edge. I'm dancing out on the edge. Out on the edge, yeah. Out on the edge. Out on the edge, yeah. Out on the edge. Out on the edge.
I think the new album's very good. I think it's in the Hooters tradition. They're a band that really relies on a big beat, strong melodies, very strong songwriting, which is all over this album, and very well balanced in terms of mid-tempo ballads and rockers.
I think Out of Body is the best album the Hooters have done since Nervous Night, and maybe their best album ever. Actually, I think it really is the best album ever.
The songs, I think, really showcase the band in all of their abilities, sort of not only the pop sensibilities that they have, but the depth things, the ability to incorporate other instruments into their sound, I think is one of my favorite parts of them, the different little, from the accordions to the penny whistles to the different elements that they incorporate musically. I think they've done the best job of balancing that on this album as opposed to any other thing they've done so far.
Every song has its story. Every song has got a beginning and a middle and an end. And, you know, and there's the story of how the song was written and the story of how the song was recorded and the story of what the song is about and, you know, how it relates to us personally or professionally. You know, as a whole, the album is probably about the past 3 years. The album is about the making of the album. There are a lot of personal stories that go into it. You know, the personal changes that you go through, and all the various the ups and downs that we've had in these years. But I think that the album as a whole really, really speaks.
I like Private Emotion. I think that's really good. I think one of the things I really liked about the band, and as songwriters, their lyrics bring you in. You can kind of hear the story. It tells you things, and that's what it takes. You know, it's important lyrics, meaningful, and then the melodies that you remember.
Most of the time, we have to go back and forth and twist and tweak them, and it's a long process. It can take months till we're really satisfied. Even in the studio, we're always changing things. Private Emotion kind of dropped in our laps. All You Zombies was another song. It's pretty rare occurrence, and I wish it was more frequent, because when it happens, you really know it's right. And we wrote that in Antigua in the middle of a thunderstorm, and we were sitting around, and I think Eric just came up with the title. I don't know, we were just throwing around this phrase, Private Emotion, and he goes, yeah, and it goes like this, and he starts playing the mandolin like it was already written. We kind of knew, and then we just got right into it, and in a couple hours it was virtually done. We changed a few lines, but it was one of the first songs we wrote for this album back in 1990, and we knew then, as soon as it was finished, that it was special, and it kind of has held up that way.
Every endless night has a dawning day. Every darkest sky has a shining ray. It takes a lot to laugh as the tears go by, but you can find me here till your tears run dry. Oh, it's a private emotion that fills you tonight, and the silence falls between us as the shadows steal the light. And wherever you may find it, wherever it may lead, let your private emotion come to me. Let your private emotion come to me. Let your private emotion come to me. Come to me. Come to me.
Big American Car to me is a killer. It's a metaphor for lost youth, or it's a metaphor for America's fall from grace. The big old American car that they can't get started anymore.
In the backyard, you can call her a dinosaur. There's a heart still beating there, baby, that's what dreams are for. That's for sure. If we'd ride right through the darkness, and sometimes we'd go too far, but the good times rolled away too soon in my great big American car. Yeah, we'd ride right through the darkness, and sometimes we'd go too far, but the good times rolled away too soon in my great big American car. Big American car. Hey, hey, hey!
last couple of albums, what they've started to do is write with other people. So they were able to get out to Nashville and go down to the islands and bounce around and meet different people who they've crossed paths with over the years and write songs with them. So Rob and Eric sat down, write with the band, or they've sat down and written with other people. And that work is evident on the last album and on this album, where they've brought in the influences of other writers to kind of gel with themselves, and also brought in Mindy, who brings that other sound. And the rest of the band is so incredible, too. I mean, you can't say enough about John Lilly, who was a guitar player with Robert Hazard and the Heroes when they scooped him up. David Wasikinen is one of the best drummers in the country. He is wanted. He lives in Los Angeles now, doesn't live in Philly anymore. He's wanted as a studio musician all the time out in L.A. And but his first, you know, his first priority is to his pals in the Hooters, which is cool. Also, Fran Smith Jr. is an incredible bass player. After Andy left, they were fortunate to hook up with him. He really fits into the style of things that they do. And also Mindy. So you combine all those people who happen to, they've known each other a long time, they get along well, and they have a lot of fun when they're out on the road. And it makes for a really nice unit.
It was funny, I saw them at the Chestnut Cabaret, it's a pretty small setting, and there were, all of a sudden there were six Hooters. It just, like, wow. It's, it seems like such a big band now. And it's amazing that just the addition of one person could make me feel that way. But I think she adds a nice dynamic. She's got the great harmonies, and when she plays her violin, that's a really neat sound. So I think it's great. It's good to see a woman up there.
She adds a high-end warmth to the blend that is really good, as well as some wonderful, wonderful violin playing. She would probably call it fiddle playing, because her violin sounds too serious and classical. But she's really she's a trained player, and it shows, and brings that country quality that the Hooters already had, brings that more forward.
Another great break for them came a couple of years back when Roger Waters decided to mount the show at the Wall in Berlin after the Berlin Wall had fallen. And he had become friends with them, and so he asked them to be a part of it. And I flew to Berlin to see that show. It was one of the best concerts I've ever seen, the whole scale of his thing. And them getting to be a part of it was a great, great thrill for them. You talk to them person for person in the band. They were just ecstatic about being there. That is a great testament to their ability to be popular overseas, particularly in Europe. They're tremendously liked.
They're successful to the point that they could release a record and go to Europe and play in Europe before they play in the States. So they're fairly well plugged into the European markets.
It's becoming less foreign. It's starting to feel like going to New Jersey. I mean, it's not radically different. I mean, I do remember the first time we went over, I think it was in 87, and we did some promotion, and then we actually started playing, and I was, you know, had my camera out the whole time, and wow, this is so foreign. And it doesn't feel that foreign anymore. We've done a number of trips to Europe and Japan, but there are new cities and there are new experiences, but it's all based on the music. Somehow they have embraced our sound.
Klockan den är 7:05. Amerikanska gruppen The Hooters är tillbaka med låten 25 Hours a Day.
Nu är de hos oss igen med fjärde albumet Out of Body.
I'm interested in your name, Hooters, what's that?
Ah, well, here's where it all started.
That's a hooter.
Melodica, yeah, we call it the hooter.
Albumet Out of Body, och för dem så ska vi höra 25 Hours a Day med The Hooters.
In a lot of ways, when we put out a record here, it's like we're starting over again. In Europe, we went back there for the first time in 3 years, and it was just like we'd never left.
The Hooters sound, it's got a lot of folk influences. It's got island influences. It's got classic, classic rock and roll, of going back to the Beatles. That idea that every song has to have a really good hook, and words that grab you right away but make you think.
I just really think that Rob and Eric are great songwriters, and that's the key to any success story. And I mean, it's just like all the greats, you know, Lennon and McCartney with the Beatles, and Elton John and Bernie Taupin, and these people that write together. And Rob and Eric met back in the University of Pennsylvania, you know, and they've just been together for years. And they have that, you know, that little whatever it is that it takes, that synergy, and they write great songs. And that's what's made them such a great success, I think.
I can't think of a group of people that I would rather see be successful, even larger than they are now. They certainly are deserving of it. They worked incredibly hard for the things that they've got, and they've got some magical experiences that have happened to them so far, but in my opinion, they deserve even more, and this town should be very, very proud of them. They represent it very well.
I think that they're exceptional ambassadors in that they are Philadelphia derivative, and that they speak highly of Philadelphia. I think they use Philadelphia. There's a shot on the album that's used with the Ben Franklin Bridge in the background. And they've done videos in Philadelphia. And it's been important for a lot of artists, I think, from big urban center areas like Philadelphia or Boston or New York or Chicago. They need to keep that, for their own sake, they need to keep that connection with home. And the Hooters do a good job of that.
We've done a lot of work away from here. You know, we've spent a lot of time away. I spent a lot of time out of Philadelphia the past couple of years. And somehow or other, though, it seems like we've got to come back here to make a Hooters record, to turn it into Hooters songs. It's just, maybe it's something in the water.
Hey!
Everyone, and should you fall, that's all.